I spread peanut butter on one side, spread peanut butter on both sides, provide an inferior sandwich. Next, you spread a thick layer of jelly onto the whiteboard with a slice of bread. You can only spread the jelly on the whiteboard. You may only spread jelly on one side. Spreading jelly on both sides will provide an inferior sandwich. You cannot spread jelly onto the same slice of bread onto which you have spread peanut butter. Also, you cannot spread peanut butter or jelly onto one slice of bread, as this will provide an undesired excess of either ingredient. Additionally, only peanut butter and jelly can be spread on slices of bread. No other ingredients will suffice, and no substitute can be used in sandwich if it is to be legitimately recognized as a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Likewise, only bread may be the substance upon which the peanut butter and jelly will spread, as anything else does not fit the standards of a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. If the peanut butter and jelly are spread onto a culinary medium that is not bread, the meal at hand simply is not a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Once you have accomplished spreading a thin layer of peanut butter onto the white of one side of one slice of bread, and likewise have been accomplished using grape jelly on a separate slice of must match the slices of bread up to each other, forming a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. In this scenario, the peanut butter covered base of bread must be facing the jelly covered base of the second slice of bread so that the peanut butter surface will be touched the surface of the jelly. The surface of the peanut butter is not allowed to touch a jellyless substance of bread, resulting in the jelly facing upwards, and likewise applies to the jelly. The substance is down facing on the outside of the sandwich. The product will not be accepted as a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. The side with peanut butter and the side with jelly must match up and stick together to form one solid sandwich. When the eater picks up the sandwich, he or she must hold both pieces of bread at the same time, or else one slice will fall off. In eating, only one slice of bread would not be recognized as the same or even similar to eating a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Next, you must take a bite of the sandwich. This action will consist of moving the sandwich within such a close proximity of your face as a small bite of the sandwich will enter your mouth for you to measure your teeth. This bite must be a bite that includes both slices of bread, peanut butter, and jelly. Not including peanut butter, jelly, parts of the sandwich may be thrown away or given to someone else. This is your sandwich and your responsibility. For the dining experience to be completed, the sandwich must be completely digested. In this context, the complete process of consuming a legitimate peanut butter and jelly sandwich, there are no extenuating circumstances. Essential just vomiting, surgical removal of the sandwich from the body, replacement of the sandwich inside the lungs opposed to the esophagus, will not be taken into account as they are not resulting in the complete digestion of a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. The process must come to a close via rectal excrement of feces that have been provided by the digestion of the peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Once the peanut butter and jelly sandwich fuel feces have exited the rectum, must remain free from the rectum to be considered conclusive in the process of physically processing a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and the feces re-enter the rectum.